Buddy, we are here today with a new topic, capital market. As you can see, capital market is bifurcated into two, that is primary market and secondary market. Primary market, which is also known as new issue market, actually the securities are issued by the company for the first time in this market, and these are bought by the savers in this primary market. The secondary market is also known as stock exchange, where the second hand securities are traded. Let us look for the features of capital market. It is actually a long term financial needs market. It establishes the link between the savers and the investors, and it determines the capital formation for the productive activities. Now, its first bifurcation, that is the primary market. New issue market, the direct capital formation takes place because the securities are offered in this primary market by the business firms, which are subscribed or bought by the savers for the first time. So the money moves from saver to the investor. The securities which are traded in this market are debentures, equity shares, preference shares and bonds. Now let us move to the secondary market. It is also known as stock exchange. The second hand securities are bought and sold here. That means no direct capital formation. Rather, it maintains the liquidity because the securities are bought and sold between the two household savers and not to the business firm. Let us move to the next topic, methods of flotation or issue of securities in the primary market. How many methods are there to bring the new issue in the primary market? Let us begin with the first method. These methods are asked for 6 marks in the board examination 2 years back. 4 points have to be written, where half mark was there for the heading and 1 mark for the explanation. So listen to it very carefully. The first method of issue is issue through prospectus. Now, what is this prospectus? Prospectus actually is that written document in which the general public is informed about the issue in the primary market. Now, the information which is declared by the company in the prospectus is very, very important. What they declare is how many funds are raised, from which source they are raised, what is the past performance of the company, what are its future plans or prospects. Such type of information actually helps the saver to know about the risk and the return potential of the company, and they can take the decision of investing in a particular company or not investing. Let us move to the second method, that is offer for sale. Here in the first method, the securities were directly issued by the business firms to the savers, but in this there are two-step method. First, the securities are sold to the intermediary, who are generally the brokers of the company. And then these intermediaries afterwards issue these securities to the general public at a profit. Why this method is used? To save the companies from so much of complexity and the formalities involved in the direct issues, like appointing the underwriter and listing the company and many other formalities. It saves the company from that. The yet another method of flotation in the primary market is private placement. As you can see, the securities are sold by the companies to few selected investors like UTI, that is Unit Trust of India, LIC, Life Insurance Corporation, GIC, General Insurance Corporation, etc. Instead of offering it to the general public. What is the benefit of that? It becomes less expensive and helpful in raising the small amount. It is much faster way of raising the funds than offering to the general public. The next method of flotation is right issue. Right means it is your right, preferential right. Existing shareholder, whenever the new issue is brought by the company, the existing shareholders are offered the new securities first in the proportion of the shares they are having earlier, before they are offered to any outsider. This is known as right issue.
Fine.
The fifth method of flotation is EIPOs. That means electronic initial public offer. When the securities are issued through the online system of a stock exchange, it is known as EIPO. IPO, the first method which we have discussed, that is issue of the prospectus, that was IPO, that was initial public offer, whereas it is EIPO taking the help of online system to offer the securities in the market. Here what the company need is the shares of the company are to be listed on any other stock exchange other than it has offered its securities earlier. That means whenever the company has raised its capital earlier, it must have listed its shares on any of the stock exchanges, for example BSE. Then for offering the next issue through the online system, it has to get itself listed on any other stock exchange, say NSE.